In this video, we will show how to disassemble the cylinder heads of a VW Type 1 engine, and what challenges you may face. First, a word of warning before you disassemble the cylinder heads. If the engine has 100,000 kilometers and more, or if it has been running too hot, then disassembling the cylinder heads means you will have to do a total engine overhaul. This is a drawing of a 1949 Type 1 engine. The parts may look different for other build years, but the principle remains the same until the end of production. Due to heat, the cylinder heads, cylinders, and engine crankcase will expand. The cylinder heads suffer the most. Due to the heat, they will expand and push against the cylinders, pushing the cylinders into the crankcase. Here we show such a cylinder head that was pressed into the cylinders. The cylinders have been pushed into the material of the cylinder head. The grooves in the material are both visible and tangible. This will cause a fuel mixture leak, also air will be sucked in. You will need to flatten the cylinder heads, as well as the engine crankcase, and to do this the engine will have to be completely disassembled. Here we have our AB1300 engine hanging from the engine mount. But, the cylinder heads can also be easily disassembled when the engine is on the workbench. This VW Type 1 engine was completely overhauled not too long ago. So, the cylinder heads should come off easily. We expect them to be in good condition. We recommend to mark all parts before disassembling them. This is the right cylinder head. We mark cylinder number 1 and 2. In video 14, we disassembled the rocker arms and pushrods. Watch video 14 of this series to learn more about that. The valve cover tensioner bracket may be removed. The cylinder head is attached to the crankcase with 8 threaded rods, with 8 nuts with washers. The upper cylinder head nuts are directly accessible. The lower 4 nuts become accessible once the rocker shaft is disassembled. If it is a used engine, such as this 1600 injection engine, we recommend applying penetrant oil to the cylinder head nuts to make disassembly easier. To avoid warping the cylinder head while torquing, the VW workshop manual gives the order of tightening the nuts in a handy drawing. Tightening large parts is always starting from the center, then the outside follows. Now use the reverse order to loosen the cylinder heads. Start with the outside nuts, then the nuts in the middle. So we start with the outer nuts crosswise, then the inner nuts. We start at nut number 8, then 7, then 6. Through 1, from the VW workshop manual drawing. Loosen nut 8, a quarter turn. Then nut 7, loosen a quarter turn, and so on, up to nut 1. You repeat this until the tension on each nut is gone. Once the tension is gone, you may loosen the nuts in any order. Remove the nuts and their washers. The back of the bottom 4 washers should be sealed with liquid gasket to prevent engine oil from leaking. So, it is most likely that the bottom 4 washers will stick to the cylinder head. You can remove those later on the workbench. We use a magnet to keep the washers from getting lost. Keep the washers in a safe place. They are still usable in most cases. On a high mileage engine, chances are there is very little tension left on the 8 nuts. This is due to the expansion and contraction of the cylinder head, as mentioned earlier. The order in which the cylinder head nuts are loosened has little importance in this case. There is no tension left on them anyway. Such a heavily used engine will therefore show leaks between cylinder head and cylinders, in the form of carbon deposits coming from the exhaust gases. There is also a chance that while unscrewing the cylinder head nuts, the threaded rods will turn with them out of the crankcase. This is not a problem, the threaded rods will have to be disassembled and replaced in a total engine overhaul anyway. In this case, unscrew the nut, along with the threaded rod, from the engine crankcase. Now you should be able to pull the cylinder head loose, by alternately pulling left and right. If the engine has a lot of mileage, the pushrod tubes may stick to the cylinder head or the crankcase, or both. Here you can see that they come off easily. This is because this engine has low mileage. If they are very stuck on both sides, you will find it difficult to pull off the cylinder head without using brute force. It is much easier in this case to cut the pushrod tubes to pieces. They cannot be reinstalled in many cases anyway. Make sure the pushrods are removed from the pushrod tubes. If the cylinder head moves little, after cutting away the pushrod tubes, you can use a rubber mallet. Tap gently with the rubber mallet in the longitudinal direction of the cooling fins. Never tap transversely against the cooling fins. The cooling fins are very strong in the longitudinal direction, but in the transverse direction you knock them to pieces without exerting much force. The rubber gaskets of 3 pushrod tubes stick in the crankcase. We store them together with the other parts of this cylinder head. It is recommended to also disassemble the cylinders, once the cylinder heads were disassembled, to avoid leaks. We discuss that in video 18 of this series. The cylinder heads will need to be thoroughly inspected if you want to reinstall them. In video 5 of our engine diagnostic series, we'll explain what to look for when overhauling the cylinder heads. But first, we'll disassemble and reassemble the valves from the cylinder heads. We'll do that in video 16 of this engine overhaul series. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments under each video on our YouTube channel. See you soon!